Magandang umaga po sa inyong lahat. Sabi po kasi sa akin, 30 minutes lang yung misa. Kasi may pasok pa kayo. No? Kaya, iiklian ko yung ating reflection. No? The readings are so beautiful. But, they are all challenging. No? The least among you all is the greatest. No? Yung pinakamaliit sa atin, yun ang pinakadakila. And that is how we must treat the little ones. No? We must learn how to welcome them. No? And these little ones are who? They are the last, the least, and those who are lost. No? Because it is to them that the kingdom of God belongs according to the Beatitudes. Anyone who is not against us is for us. No? A call to openness. No? A call to let people feel that they belong. No? A call to all of us to be welcoming in whatever church we are building. Sadly, we live in a world that is very competitive, a time that is very competitive. People are competing for attention, competing for position. People are competing for power and placement in societies, in groups, in communities. And when this is happening, it is not far that we will begin labeling, no, one another, especially labels of uselessness, unimportance, and burdensome. No? Kapag tayo ay may attitude, no, na we are competing, no, ang unang may itsipwera sa community natin, yung mga bata at yung mga matatanda. No? One of the greatest pains of people who are retiring is that they feel useless. Wala na akong silbi. Inutil na ako. Wala na akong kita. And that is sad. No? We are beginning to build private boundaries. No? Boundaries of exclusivity against the poor. No? Against the sick. Against the dying. But the gospel tells us what attitude, no, must we have? It is the attitude of service. No? Service to the old, service to the young, service to the sick and dying in our company. No? Jesus, no, is telling us it is not about racing against each other, but it is a matter of journeying with each other. Why? Because every person matters. No? Lahat ng tao may kabuhulugan, may kahulugan. May worth, no, sa ating buhay. No? And that is precisely what the current synod is all about, the synod on synodality. No? Every person's opinion counts. That is why everyone, no, every person was consulted. All of us answered the questions. No? And it tells us that there are three ways, no, that we must cross, three ways that we must try, no, and walk through in our lives. The first one is the path of communion. We are gathered as one body, gathered to be one mind, one faith, one direction, one vision, one mission. And this will happen, no, as we express and experience our own differences with each other. Lahat tayo magkakaiba. No? Lahat tayo hindi para pareho ang gusto. No? But it is the Holy Spirit that guides us. No? The Holy Spirit that teaches us how to live with our differences. No? Na yung ating pagkakaiba-iba ay hindi dahilan para tayo magkawatak-watak. No? Our differences, our paths, so that we can help one another, support each other. No? That is how we become one. No? To try and complete the picture in the puzzle by our own uniqueness. Second, the path of participation. Everyone has a voice. Every voice counts. No? So do not be afraid to share your voice. No? Do not be afraid, no, to give your opinion, your suggestions. That is how we can grow. Hindi lang ito, no, idea ng kakaunti. No? Hindi lang ito, no, bubuin dung matatalino lamang. No? To find worth in the voice of the little ones, the voiceless even, is a very big challenge for us. No? The third path is mission. We need to proclaim the good news. We need to become witnesses, no, to the love of God. That is our mission as Christians. Communion, participation, and mission. Let us think about that. No? Para yung ating misa, hindi lang 30 minutes. No? Para yung ating upuan, puno. No? Para yung ating buhay sa labas ng simbahan ay maging tunay, kasi kasama lahat, no? Lahat kasama sa buhay natin sa pag-ibig ng Diyos. Amen.